video, we're going to look at the concept of ledger entries. Now, we're going to look at customer ledger entries specifically, but as you may have noticed in NAV, a lot of the time it takes a concept and it applies it to multiple areas. So ledger entries, as I mentioned, we're going to look at customer ledger entries, but they also exist for vendor ledger entries, there's item ledger entries, there's capacity ledger entries. So basically, whenever a transaction is posted, it becomes history, and history goes into what we call a ledger. And with that, we get an ongoing list of all of the history of that item or that vendor, and then or customer in this example. And then what we can do is we can leverage our filtering to be able to answer any questions we may have about the history of that different area. So let's jump into NAV and take a look. Here we are on our trusty roles center. And what we can do is we could always, if we wanted to, navigate to, say, a customer card. And then from the ribbon here, we have the ability to see our ledger entries. So what we can do is we can go to a customer, we highlight that customer, and we select on ledger entries. And as you can see here, we've just got a little bit of sample data here, but I can see that there was a payment to this customer. I can see that we've done multiple invoices to that customer. And if we add a filter here under document type, you can see that within a ledger, we would have the ability to see any one of these document types if we had more data in here. So we'd be able to see any payments that they made, invoices that were created for them, credit memos that were created for them, finance charges, reminders, and refunds. So say, for example, we had a question specifically about invoices that were sent to that customer. We could use our filtering to be able to have document type is invoice. So again, you'll see that that payment came off. And say, for example, this was a large list and we knew what the invoice number was, but we weren't 100% sure, you know, any more detail about it. We can always leverage these single filterings here. So say, for example, we knew that invoice 1004 was the description. So from there, we had the ability to, from the advanced filter, continue to add filters if we needed to. We could leverage the filtering on the top right here, and we had the ability to take that huge list of that customer history and filter down to the individual details that we needed. When we have that individual line item, we may say, well, this is great, but I don't have all the information that I need. I actually still need to see that. I can use my ribbon up here and I could show that posted document. So as you can see, what this did was it opened up my posted sales invoice. So now I had the information on the line, but here I could easily drill into that specific document and I have even more information. So I can see all the header information, I can see the line information, I could drill into the line information. So say, for example, if there was a comment or serial or lot information that I wanted to see, I could do that. I could drill in and basically answer any question that I needed to. I could then drill into the customer card and see information about the customer if I had to. So I have the ability there to be able to, as I mentioned, go to my customer ledger entries, see all of the history, see all of the postings that happened, and then again, once I've done all of my filtering and I'm down to the individual record that I need, I have the ability to then open up the posted document and drill into that document if I need to see more information that maybe isn't present. I could also use this navigate button here, and from this navigate button, when this invoice was posted, there were a few different related entries that happened. So a posted sales invoice was created, and again, we were able to navigate to that using the posted document. There were some general ledger entries that were created, tax entry entries that were created, the customer ledger entry was created, obviously, because we highlighted on that. We've got the detailed customer and the value entries. So when we click on the navigate, say, for example, you wondered, well, what were those six GL entries? You can always highlight that line, select the ellipsis here, and now we've drilled into the general ledger entries that were created as a result of posting this invoice. So this is more on the accounting side, so we won't dig too much into that, But basically what we want to highlight here is that when you look for your customer ledger entries, or as I mentioned, your item or vendor ledger entries, you have the ability to see the entire history of items and then drill in to get more information on that if you needed to. You could also use the Send to Excel button, or using Control E on your keyboard, you could send this information to Excel if you wanted. And then from there, you may say, well, I want to see all of the invoices between a certain month. So you would use your posting date. Let's just say, for example, 1/1/2017... So we're basically saying, I want to see everything from January 1st last year to today. When you tab off of there, we would clear this. We would be able to see all of those invoices. Maybe you like that information, but you want to use it in a pivot chart or add a little summary. So the ability to be able to send these ledger entries directly to Excel is really nice, because then you can open up those entries in Excel. And then, as I mentioned, from there, you've got all of the fun stuff that Excel provides, like creating formulas and new columns. Again, you could take that information, you could insert a pivot table, you can do all kinds of things with this information now.
As always, if you have any questions, feel free to contact us. Here's our phone number information, or as well, you can email at info@sabrelimited.com. Thanks for watching.